Transit brings optimism, feeling good, good news. This is one of the best transit for making plans because of your good instincts. Ideal time to declutter. Or setting off on a journey is very favorable at this time. Hi everyone, I'm Alia with Esther with Alia.com here with your weekly Esther forecast for July the 12th to the 17th of 2021. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you're new to my channel, welcome. And if you're already part of my Esther tribe, welcome back. At the end of this video, I have information on crystal that you can use in your meditation for this week's planetary energy. So do stick around until the end if you are interested in finding that out. Also, my astrology reading giveaway where I'm actually giving away one full free reading this month is still going on until the 21st of July, which means this free reading giveaway will end on Wednesday next week. And the information on how to enter the giveaway is in the description box below. So if you're interested, please do check that out. And also, please share it with your friends and family. You can enter as many times as you like. Just follow the easy three steps to enter each time. So this week, we start the week with very harmonious energy and end the week with hot and quite challenging aspects. So with that said, let's get into our weekly forecast. On July 12th, Mercury trine Jupiter. Now, Mercury trine Jupiter transit brings optimism, feeling good, you know, balanced thinking, and good news. It's a great time to get involved with groups, activities, research, study, and socializing. And this is one of the best transit for making plans because of your good instincts, future-oriented and positive thinking, right? This is also the ideal time to declutter, clean up and organize your space, right? Great time for planning that trip that you've been wanting to go. Or setting off on a journey is very favorable at this time, especially long distance travel, international travel. Your open-mindedness and progressive outlook enables you to increase your general knowledge and expand your horizon. A particular area of study which may interest you includes religion, law, language, and philosophy. Business dealing should also go well, and this is an excellent time for any intellectual pursuit. Legal matters, proposals, you know, entering into negotiations, and for signing contracts. This can be a very, very fortunate time with good luck increasing your level of happiness and satisfaction. Making friends come easy with this energy, and mutually beneficial friendships can really prove profitable in the future as well. On July 13th, Venus will conjunct Mars. Now, Venus conjunct Mars transit will make us feel romantic and sexy, right? Very driven by an intense need for sexual satisfaction. Due to our raw passion and sex appeal, which can make us highly attractive to a potential partner. And this increased charisma and popularity makes socializing more enjoyable and exciting as well. It's such a fabulous energy. This is a fabulous time for both romance and making new friends. You will also find satisfaction in creative activities such as art, music, dancing and painting. Even routine work should be more enjoyable now as we have the drive and creative urge to make things look and work better. An excellent time, you know, to host a party or celebration. Really, really fun time. So really enjoy this energy. On July 15th, Sun trines Neptune. Now, Sun-Neptune transit stimulates imagination and inspiration and increase our sensitivity to our environment and our empathy for others. We may have an urge to help others in need or join, you know, charity, welfare groups and organizations. I mean, we may gain a deeper and wider understanding of our place in the world as well. Importantly, we may realize that achieving our goals and dreams is of prime importance before we can really, you know, go ahead and help others. This transit will really help us set goals to manifest our hopes and dreams for the future. Strong faith and morals means you know, means that we can stay true to our spiritual ideals without really sacrificing our own needs or level of comfort. Our ego benefits from a more spiritual outlook, enabling us to really work hard on achieving success. Our path to success can be helped by strong belief, even psychic impressions, which could be more accurate now. This is a good energy, a really beneficial energy for marketing, selling, advertising, and all artistic and creative talents are heightened, you know, at this time. It's a good time to really start such projects right now. This would also be a good time to learn more about religion or other sort of spiritual beliefs, right? We can more easily comprehend occult subjects like astrology and tarot, as well as promote our interests in groups. This transit is good for socializing in general and for partnerships as well. Existing relationships will enjoy more spiritual closeness and bonding, and sexual relationship would be more tender and loving. New relationships, you know, form now could be with a sensitive or more spiritual types of partners and may come from, you know, involvement in groups or clubs. A new relationship would also benefit from a shared vision of future happiness together. What a beautiful energy. Definitely enjoy it. We definitely need these energies because we are going to now have on July 17th, Sun in opposition with Pluto, which is a harsh energy. Now, Sun opposite Pluto transit can indicate some kind of crises, right? Either with self-esteem, a relationship, or an event. This may be due to a self-destructive character trait such as addiction, stubbornness, inflexibility. In relationship, you may feel blocked or undermined by outside forces or people, and you may also be the subject of or the perpetrator of power struggle, control issues, manipulations, you know, jealousy, domination, or possible spying as well. Events may include your car breaking down, broken appliances, or maybe theft and violence, or the destruction of, you know, possessions by people, or a natural disaster is also very, very possible with this energy. So it is quite volatile. This energy plays out in this manner. It is important not to be overly assertive, egotistic, or, you know, resistant to change. Things like this will more likely, you know, to happen if you have been stubbornly resisting change. You may feel that things are totally out of your control. In a way, they help you realize that you don't need to have total control over others or your environment, right? Even though you may experience a bruised ego during this transit, there is also a great potential for positives as well, but only if you're open to change. This change may be forced upon you, you know, so this transit can feel less disruptive. The aim is really to transform for better, right? Become aware of your issues related to power and control can facilitate tapping into your hidden inner, you know, resources and to evolve your soul so that you may live a better life and experience more satisfaction in your life, right? So the crystal I thought for this week, and I would like to recommend for this week's energy, is the beautiful ruby, which will help with the intense, you know, Sun in opposition with Pluto energy. So ruby crystal stimulates the heart chakra and assists us in the selection and attainment of our ultimate values. It further stimulates a loving emotional side towards nurturing, bringing spiritual wisdom, health, knowledge, and wealth. Ruby is known as the stone of nobility, gathering and amplifying energy while promoting and stimulating mental concentration. It can improve success in controversies and disputes, encouraging gentleness and discouraging violence, and is so important for this energy. It is an excellent shielding stone, protecting on all levels and safeguarding one's consciousness from psychic attack as well. Now, this energy of ruby is intense and vivid, bringing lucidity to the dream state and really conveying understanding and control of the role and action of the mental state upon the physical realm. Ruby encourages one to follow bliss. It is said that ruby will light the darkness of one's life, right? Giving giving birth to a spark of light which progressed throughout the body and spirit, conquering darkness on all levels. What a gorgeous, gorgeous stone. So profound. The energy can assist one in changing one's world, promoting creativity and expansiveness in awareness and manifestations. So such an incredible stone to wear at this time with this energy, because it is a harsh energy. There is light with this energy as well, if we hone into it, you know, if we understand it, and if we understand the way this energy is playing out, we're able to then conquer so much positivity in our lives. So that wraps up for this week's forecast. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm wishing you such a fabulous, fabulous week. We do have some harmonious, great energies coming our way, so do enjoy that. And you know, of course, then we have a bit of harsh energies, and they're okay to enjoy as well, because we know what we are doing, right? If you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe to my channel, and share the video with your friends if you think they might be interested or benefit from the information I shared with you today. And make sure that you are also following me on Instagram and Facebook for more astrology updates and insight. And as always, always remember to smile and know that you're absolutely beautiful. Take care. I will see you next week. Bye for now.